Hi everyone, my name's Leith Forreston from Radio Station 5AA here with cycling superstar Annette Edmondson. This is a very exciting day here in Adelaide and a very exciting day for the cycling sport in general, Nettie, because we are at a brand new event here in Beverley for, well, it's just going to be exciting, the Blackchrome Velo Grand Prix. What can we expect as people are tuning in now on the live stream?
It is a hot, fast, short circuit. It's only 1.5 laps of this circuit, so it's a course that suits both short style sprinters and longer endurance riders. So it suits the track, it suits the road riders. We don't know what to expect. This is the first type of Grand Prix of this kind, so I'm really excited to be here today with Blackchrome Sportswear and really see how it unfolds.
The beauty of this sport is it's almost like speed skating that we see in the Winter Olympics, but on a cycling perspective. It's a short track, but it's going to be very fast and it's going to be just action-packed.
Absolutely. We've got about 30 male entrants. We have about 12 females, so there's going to be some hot, fast, short groups, and so it'll be head-to-head, four up in a heat, and the first two from each round will progress, with the other two being eliminated.
Let me ask you, and I know we've spoken to the crowd who are gathered here in Beverley already, but it is a new event. We're not quite sure how the riders will partake it. Is it just first to the first corner and then just try and maintain that lead, or can you expect some sort of cat and mouse behavior this afternoon?
Well, we've got two long straights here, so I feel it depends on the speed of each round. So if someone puts the gas down too hard, then if you're sitting nice and tucked away on that wheel, you'll be getting that recovery. So that could be important for the final kick. So you really have to see how each round is raced. And I think that's definitely going to be an advantage being in the eighth heat, because they'll have a lot of heats to learn. And who knows?
You're a superstar in the Olympics, the Commonwealth Games, the World Champs, etc. Are you taking the lead? Are you going to the front early and maintaining the lead? Or would you just drop back behind someone, a little bit of slipstream, and then when you get close to the finish, you just take off?
I think I would take it a little bit cautiously from the start. I feel like I would be wanting to be in a good position for that second last corner down the other end. I don't want to be going too far behind. But then by the time we get to the final corner, I'd want to be up in the first one or two places to make sure I'm first across the line.
It's going to be an action-packed afternoon. You'll see it all here. Make sure you continue to enjoy the live stream. Annette Edmondson will be back soon with more action.
All right, so we're up to the heat one. We're about to commence the very first heat. So there's only two riders in this heat because we've had a pull out from this morning. We have Lee Howard in the red helmet cover, David Miller in the light blue. This will be a pretty exciting final because Dave Miller has actually got a bit of speed. He's a bit of a sprinter. Lee Howard is also fast. He's on the track. But there's money up for grabs. So even though they will both progress, there's definitely some motivation there to get across the line first.
All right, so two and a half. How do you think they're going at in terms of pace? They don't seem to be. They're just cruising at this stage. Mind you, the first two go through, so there are a fair chance to go through the next heat, these two boys.
I feel like their odds are quite high. I did make a mistake. I thought it was 1.5. It's actually 2.5 laps. So when two of them go through, they can afford to take it a little bit more cruisy before the action heats up in the next lap.
So tell us a little bit about Lee as he turns here. So, cyclists.
Yeah, one lap to go here. So Lee Howard, he's been part of the track team for quite a while. He actually was a road professional for a few years there. So he's got a lot of experience, so he'll know when to move and when not to. However, he's coming into this corner first, so it'll be interesting to see what happens down this back straight going into the final bend. Dave does have a bit of speed on him, so I wouldn't be too complacent. And they've actually gone pretty hard down this back straight, so Dave Miller has had the sit on the wheel, but will he have enough time to come around in that final straight across the line? And Lee does it pretty easily. I think they're trying to save something for the next rounds to come.
Well done.
Still a good ride.
Very good strategy too when you're both going through. So you just get a look at the course, have a look, work out what we need to do in terms of turning circles. See, now we've got a bit more. Now there's a bit more to worry about. And that when their field is full, two through. So here we have Nobes in the dark blue helmet. Blue. Josiah Whittaker in the red helmet. The three riders.
So we've got 10 seconds to go.
So a gentle first turn, and then you expect them to explode down the straight.
Depends on the tactic here. You can see Josiah Whittaker wants to get to the front. He's moved up into second wheel. He's not happy being in third. The tactics definitely change when there's an extra rider in there. You've got more people to watch. So the problem is if you're in... Oh, we've had a crash at the other end.
So Josiah's fallen.
Josiah Whittaker down. The other two are okay. Josiah's straight back on. We've got Glenn Nobes as attacked, making an early hit. And then we've got Alan Hinks chasing. We've still got one lap to go, so it's... still a long time, it's a long way out, but if he can maintain that gap.
And I think Josiah's retired from this race.
So Alan Hinks is in hot pursuit. The gap staying similar size, so whether he can make it there by the end to take that prize money at the finish line. So they took it a bit more carefully that last time around that corner. We've got Glenn Nobes still in front. Now that gap is coming down. Alan Hinks is coming back at him. Can Glenn hit this last corner with enough speed to keep that gap? Oh, it's getting close. It's going to be a sprint to the line. Oh, I think he got there. Yeah, Alan Hinks got there. Wow, I didn't see that one coming. So they're both going to go through. Unfortunately, Josiah won't be moving through. But we've got Alan Hinks taking the prize money for that round.
So again, Annette, with a new event that we're enjoying here, these are the things that we'll learn on these corners, whether mistakes were made at that corner, whether they were too tight. If you are coming around the teardrop here, are you trying to take the left and then cut off into the right?
I think I would try and stay left as long as I can and then go straight into the right side as we go around the inside of the corner. And then as we come out, I would straight liner as well and stick to the left. However, the problem is if you stay to the left before you go into that corner, you could open up space for another rider to come on the inside. So you got to keep enough pace to stop anyone coming from round.
So this is like the T20 of cycling. There's another heat. This is race three or heat three. Josh Blake in the blue. We have Nathan Ross in the dark blue. And we have Simon Veitch in the yellow.
So Simon Veitch looks like he had a problem clipping in, so he's going to have to close that gap. We've got Josh Blake off to a quick start. Wow, he's already opened up a big gap. He's going the whole way out. This is a different tactic. We haven't seen this yet.
So again, the first two go through there for Simon to do. Is there a possibility in it that you just try and get through the curve safely and then literally try and make up what you can on the sprint?
Definitely. Depends how skilled you are at cornering. Simon Veitch struggled a little bit there, but there's a big gap. So unfortunately, he didn't get his foot clipped in, and I think that he's going to pay the price. So we've got Josh Blake out the front, huge gap. Nathan Ross in hot pursuit. So two go through. You'd think that Nathan Ross and Josh have made it, but you never know. But yes, it totally depends on how confident you are with your cornering. So I've definitely had some slip outs. So you've got to know the limit, and depends what type of risk you're willing to take.
And of course, Australia, unfortunately, has a history in the Olympics of shoes coming out. We hope Shane's not watching this. One of our greatest ever cyclists, Shane Kelly.
Yeah, that was really unfortunate. And I learned from that never to use new equipment on race day. Such a shame, because he'd won so many world titles before that race. All right, we've got Josh Blake coming in to take a nice win. Made it pretty tough out there. You might need a warm down after that one before the next race. Nathan Ross comes in second, so he will move through to the next round. Unfortunately, Simon missing out. Well, that was cool. Different tactic.
It was. It's exciting to see too when there's three in the heat. Just the tactics that the first two will do. In the end, I guess you want to just get through safely too. Make sure that doesn't happen towards you. It's a later stage of the race.
Absolutely. I think that's the priority for most people here.
So again, welcome you the Blackchrome Velo Grand Prix. We hope you're enjoying it. Those people who are here in Adelaide, bathed in sunshine. Those people who are watching it on the blackchrome.cc website, enjoying the live stream. Inaugural event. It's exciting. It's different for not only the riders, but also for the spectators, and just to see how this all plays out. Race four, or heat four, coming up very shortly. So we mentioned there are eight heats in the men's. There are four heats in the women, over $5,000 with the prize money up for grabs. Also great to have the Honourable Joe Sokarch MP, member for Cheltenham, here supporting this terrific event that we hope will become, if not an annual event. Is it a net when it's twice a year?
Biannual.
There you go.
Put me on the spot there.
Create your own unique cycling kit with Blackchrome's Kit Creator, the easiest way to design on mobile, tablet or PC. First, select your fit, then select a product. Edit colours from our huge colour range. Next, you can add graphics from our library. Scale, edit and change colours. Add custom text and your team logos. Create designs across additional products to complete your kit. Kit up and ride with Blackchrome.
So we've got 4 minutes until the next heat, so there's a little bit of a break because I think everybody is going a lot faster than we were expecting. So 4 minutes away.
So the great part of this, and much like when we see in the big pack, we want it to be fast and furious. Everyone's so excited to get onto the track that the first three heats went so quick. Now the other riders, so we just heard some word regarding Josiah, who fell down to our left. So can you walk us through, though, the chain? Able to get the chain back onto the bike to repartake in the race.
Yeah, so apparently his chain fell off as he went just before he went around the corner. So luckily it wasn't something to do with the course. So if anyone's listening who's yet to race, don't panic. But unfortunately it was stuck and he couldn't continue racing after that. So it's a shame, but unfortunately a result is a combination of an athlete and their equipment and their team behind it. So hopefully he can get that sorted ASAP.
Can you walk us through, just as we get the next heat underway, as an elite athlete, how much are you putting into the heats? How much are you trying to save in the tank for the next round as you go through?
Yeah, well, I do the Omnium on the track, which is four events. And so because of this, you've got to measure how much energy you use. So obviously the aim is to win, but if you're going to win and you've got a little bit of space, then you won't push yourself all the way to the end until the final. So there's not often that you're in a position where you can cruise, but if you are, you definitely make the most of that.
So here we are with heat four. In the dark blue, we have Harry Holloway. In the yellow, we have Matthew Fox. And in the light blue, Artis Markovs. So again, three into two does not go. This will be an exciting race.
Artis has chosen to go from the front, so he's gone around the first corner in first position. We have Matthew and Harry are fighting for second place at the moment. We've got Matthew doesn't like second position, so he's headed to the front. He wants to hit this tight corner on the front. We have Artis settling into third. They're all still tightly together. Ooh, Artis on the inside. So Matthew's going pretty hard from this last corner. He's opening up a massive gap. So it's a big gap. We've got Artis with Harry on the back. So we're coming into the bell with one lap to go. So Matthew Fox has still got a big lead. You can see him moving. He's put a lot of effort into this, but we've got the real racers behind, with Artis, with Harry sitting close behind.
So how are you playing this from a tactical point of view for the other two riders?
Well, I think the gap is too big. Matthew's going to take this out. So to make sure you get through the next round, these other two are going to have to really look at each other. Yeah, so we've got Harry going to the front now. He doesn't want to be second around that corner. He wants to make sure he goes through this next round. Artis struggling to keep up. But we've got Matthew taking the prize money today in this round. And then we got Harry coming in second. So that was a pretty solid race.
Well done. Great race. So again, as a cyclist, when you're in the race like this, how much are you watching what's going on behind of you versus how much are you just watching ahead, focusing on what you need to do?
Well, it's pretty tricky with three out there, because if you're in the front, you only have to look back. So you're looking at two people, but if you're at the back, you can look forward. So it's almost an advantage. However, I think being third wheel around that last corner is too far back. So it's tricky. Second wheel's hard because you've got to look forwards and backwards at the same time. So it's pretty tactical. There's a lot of similarities with the track sprint event, where they play the cat and mouse from first and second wheel. And when they go through the next round, or even in the Omnium elimination on the track, there's moments when you have to look forward and back. So I think you've got to have a lot of confidence and have a lot of skill to do this type of racing.
So So we'll get through the men's heats first. There are eight men's heats. Just repeating for those people who have, again, just arrived here to the track here in Beverly, it is a elimination-style race. The first two go through. If there are indeed two others in the race, they will not make it through. We have eight heats for the men, four heats for the women. Four of the men's races so far, so heat five coming up very shortly for the men, including one of the riders, Annette, that you suggested, which, of course, Olympian and one of the Australian champions, Kellen O'Brien, number two. So watch out for him in this particular race. And I wonder how the ladies are feeling too, knowing that their heats aren't far away. They are watching from, I guess, a safety point of view, but also from a tactical point of view of what the men's are doing so far in these heats.
Yeah, I certainly would be sitting there watching. Definitely worth keeping an eye out to see what sort of order wins, especially around that last corner. But also just see what type of gap you can make. If you are good at bike handling and if you can get around those corners with speed, then you've definitely got an advantage coming out.
Are you the type that would be talking to the other riders, going up to them after their heats and saying, what should I do, what should I not do?
Potentially. Yeah, definitely. If you've got, there's some teams out there that have men's teams and women's teams, so I know there'd be some close relationships, so yeah, definitely worth getting as much information as you can, because you've only got one shot, and if you make the wrong decision out there, then you could be missing out.
So this is heat five of the men's Blackchrome Sportswear Velo Grand Prix. In the red, Kellen O'Brien. In the dark blue, Darcy Strutt. And in the yellow, Willis Leanett.
So we've got 15 seconds. All right, so we have a pretty interesting field here. Willis has come from a BMX background. He's up against Kellen O'Brien and Darcy Strudwick. Kellen is the Commonwealth Games gold medalist in the team pursuit. He's also won world titles in the team pursuit. So he's right now riding for Inform. He came second at the road nationals in the road race. I'm not sure if anyone was watching. It was a pretty exciting race. So he's definitely got a bit of speed behind him. So they've taken that corner pretty carefully. Kellen was on the front, Willis in second, Darcy on the back. So Kellen's looking behind, they're being pretty tactical here. I think this is the slowest we've seen. Oh, we've had a hit move from the back in Darcy. That was a smart one. So he's coming into this corner with speed. Wow, he's moving around pretty quickly. So Kell's in second wheel, whether he chases this gap or not, or whether he wants to save. Nope, here we go, he's closed the gap. Still looking. Nobody wants to go too hard too early. Oh. All right, they've made that nasty corner. Kel's still on the front. Willis is tucked in second. Kel is hitting it down this back straight. He's going to go around the corner first. Then we've got Willis and then Darcy. So I feel like the gaps are too big for the order to change. And yes, so we have Kellen safely through and Willis in close second. Great job. Well done, Darcy. That was a good move.
So walk us through the tactics there. Kellen, we know the quality of Kellen with his CV. He seemed to have it under control, wasn't worried about the breakaway at that early stage, just held his form and then got home in the end.
Yeah, I think as you can see, he was looking around a lot. It definitely puts off other riders when you're looking at them, because it makes them not want to do anything strange, because you'll be able to react pretty quickly. And so I think that's why the gap didn't open up too much, because Kel was waiting for it. But no, that move from Darcy, it was definitely worth a shot. He came around that corner third, so he had a bit of speed chasing and he may as well have used it and gone past. But then the problem was the gap was closed too quickly and the riders were able to recover. I think if he'd managed to open up that gap, then it would definitely have worked, as we saw in some of the earlier heats. But yeah, luckily for Kel, he was paying attention.
How difficult would it be braking around these corners? As we say, a lot of who aren't cyclists, we're thinking of the turning circles of our cars and we'd have no chance. What are you doing when you're braking around, I guess, the wider teardrop versus the really thin corner on our left?
Yeah, they're both quite different. Obviously, the tighter the corner, the slower you're going to have to go. So, as you saw, all the cyclists were out doing some warm-up laps, testing it out, seeing what their limit could be. This is why it's so important to be prepared for a race. A lot of the road races overseas, everybody recons them. So that means going out with your team, checking out the roads, knowing exactly when the cobble sections are, when the narrow parts are. So on a course like this, you want to get out on the course before the gun goes, because you just don't know how fast you're going to be able to get around, and also how fast the people in front of you are going to go around, because that's also another part to play. If you don't really know how good their skills are, then perhaps you want to hit these corners from the front, but then you also don't want to use too much energy, so definitely worth being prepared.
I love the fact it's an inaugural event. It's a beautiful Sunday afternoon here in Adelaide, but the competitive juices would still be flowing. Are they the kind of athletes who would be just happy to get through? Would there be a little bit of brashness, just knowing that maybe some riders here have got the others' measure?
I think as soon as you put on a number, people race. You can always go in thinking you'll take it easy, but I don't think that's the case.
So here we have, this is men's heat number 6, Matthew Miller in the red. We have Michael Wellman in the yellow, and in the dark blue, Jonathan Wigzell.
So we have Jonathan going around in first. You might have heard the gears before jumping. That means that he was not in the right gear when he started off the line. So that's definitely worth thinking about before you clip in. But this race is on. We've got Matt Miller wanting to go to the front. Michael's in third at the moment. Here we go. Matt Miller took that. Oh, we've got one. Michael's down. So Matt Miller, he's on the front, Jonathan in second. There's a bit of a gap, whether he can close that or not. Michael Wellman is back on his bike, so that's good to see. I think he's just slipped out, maybe a little bit too fast around that corner.
So now the tactics change for the front two. They just make sure they get through.
Yep, definitely. So Matt Miller wants the money, so he's pushing on. You've got Jonathan's not giving up, so it depends. Jonathan can make a decision here. Can he close this gap? If he thinks he can, then it's worth pushing on. But if he doesn't think he'll make it, then if I was him, I'd just take it easy and save for the next round. Matt Miller digging deep, still going. And it looks like Jonathan's taking it cruisy. Just play it safe. Yeah.
So Michael Wright, but we have our winner. Matthew Miller comes first in heat number 6. Jonathan Wigzell comes over the line in second position, which means that they will both go through with 2 per heat. We hope you're enjoying the Blackchrome Sportswear Velo Grand Prix, an inaugural event. And it's wonderful, Nettie, with what we've seen with COVID and so many events have been cancelled, to have a quality field like this, a great event like this, something new, something different for the sport, for both the riders and the spectators. We hope that equally they're enjoying it. And of course, none of this can be done without the addition and help of terrific sponsors, the likes of bikeshack.com.au, Fame and Spear, Physio Fit. I could see you at Physio Fit in the activewear, just running up a storm. Oz Cycling. Again, thank you so much to the City of Charles Sturt, to SQ, Strategy Road, helping businesses, volunteer assist, Homecare Equipment, so many great sponsors able to make a day such as this possible. And I know when you first arrived, you were just blown away by how impressive this whole setup has been.
Absolutely. And speaking to some of the riders before, I think they felt the same way. It's not often that we get so much support behind bike racing here in Australia and South Australia in particular. So we're very thankful for Blackchrome for putting this on today and for everybody for coming out and supporting it, because this is the first test run. This has not been raced before. So we're kind of testing the waters here, and we're hoping to make it even bigger and better next year. So, yeah, so far so good.
So Fayman Spear, I'm told, does photography. So if they can make us look amazing, that would be nice. Don't put any of the bad ones up. You know how it works with Instagram?
Yeah, I have seen Andy floating around.
Ride so without limits with Blackchrome's complete range of custom cycling apparel.
His work is really, really
quality kit to suit every rider. Perfect for events, corporates, teams and social groups. Be prepared for all seasons. Transform your team with our online custom kit creator. Kit up and ride with Blackchrome.
It's quite a long name. But yes, occasionally post. At the moment, it's all about landscaping. Because we decided that with a bit of time on our hands through COVID, we decided to upgrade the house. And so it's time for a new shed. So I've been very busy.
So fair to say you're a little flat. You're not racing today because the $5,000 of prize money would have gone nice there at Bunnings.
I know. I was very tempted, but we are on a 7-day break, so coaches said no, not today.
It's terrific to have you on the mic. We hope you're enjoying it here in Beverly, or indeed on the blackchrome.cc website live stream. This is heat number 60 riders in this heat. Noah Piggin is in the dark blue. Phil Crick is in the light blue. And in the yellow, we have Matt Franks, number 14.
All right, and they're off from the gun, making this a fast one. So we have Matt Franks hitting the corner first. Wow. They are moving. He's opening up quite a big gap here. So it's quite tricky here for Noah, because he's got to work out whether Matt is going to continue with this effort or if he's going to ease up. So does Matt put the effort in knowing that Phil is right on the wheel? So they're all safely around that tight corner. This is a long way out. We're still going. We've still got 1.5 to go. So the gaps are staying in a similar size, though it looks like Phil is closing in.
So here Matt, we go, one lap to go. Yeah.
They're all punching out of the corner. Will they have enough energy to overtake? I'm told Matt Franks is famous for his bunny hops at the end of a cyclocross race. So it looks like he's pretty good at the short circuit on the road as well. He's got a bigger gap now, so the other two are falling behind. So if he just holds that, he'll make it through. Looks like Noah has had enough. He's been overtaken by Phil, so I think Phil might have done just enough to sneak through. Yeah, that was a pretty solid one for everyone involved, I think.
Well done.
Time to wind down. Hopefully they've brought some rollers to flush the lactic acid out of the legs. Because they're going to want to recover and get rid of that before the next race.
So talk us through that. So you've just ridden your heat. In the case of the two men have gone through, what do they do now?
Well, if I was them, it's a short race, so I knew that it would be a lot of lactate produced because everyone's sprinting for the line. Doesn't matter if you leave it late or go from the gun. Obviously, if you go from the gun, you're going to produce a bit more, so it's going to be a lot more painful. But if you get on the rollers, they're a stationary system. You can either, or an ergo, you can bring one of those along, set it up in the rider's area, and then just put it into a really light cadence and just spin the legs out. I think it's really important to keep your heart rate up so you can flush the lactic out as fast as you can. I think it would go for any sport, not just cycling. But yeah, as fast, if you keep as warm as you can, flush it out, small gears, and then get rid of that, and you feel that the legs are a lot easier. Whereas if you just went and sit down and tried to stand up a little bit later, you would definitely notice the heavy legs.
Terrific insight from world champion, Olympic Games, Commonwealth Games champion, superstar Annette Edmondson. We are joined by the local member for Cheltenham, the Honourable Joe Sokach, MP. Minister, you're enjoying this. How good is this race? How good is this atmosphere?
It's a cracker. It's a cracker. I've had to retreat to a bit of shade, being a redhead. So I'm comforted to have a bit of a shade for a moment. But it's a cracking day for it. I'm not sure what the Lions Club of Golden Grove are offering over in their tent there, but I can highly recommend it. If everyone's looking for a snag or something, I'm sure the Lions Club of Golden Grove over across the road there is going to be able to look after them.
I absolutely demolished a hamburger earlier. Annette is an elite athlete, hasn't eaten anything yet, but I'm sure you'll do that at some stage.
Hey, always come prepared.
Nettie mentioned a short time ago, Joe, about the support that cycling gets, the support that South Australia gives, that Australia gives. How important are events like these that we're seeing here from Blackchrome for building the sport and building that relationship with state government, with sponsors, and with the sport as a whole?
Well, these events speak volumes, because we've got line events that we need to make sure we think, hold on to, like the Tour Down Under. We've had such tremendous history in the state with elite cycling, with centres of excellence for decades now. But it's these smaller, more innovative events which I think do a whole lot to bring new people into the sport, people that might not trudge up the hill to watch the peloton ride past them during the Tour Down Under, or may not spend an evening out at the velodrome. But these smaller events, which are innovative, exciting, really help bring new families and new spectators into the sport.
So we're about to get underway with Heat 8. Again, it looks like just the two riders here. Looks like Matthew Bird is out of this race. So we have Juan Molina in the light blue and Scott Newstead in the dark blue. So
Interesting facts for you here today. In the light blue, we have Juan Molina, and he has been the Colombian national champion. However, not on a bike, as a swimmer. So we've had a crossover. So it'll be interesting to see if he's a sprint swimmer or endurance.
Minister for Cheltenham was a elite 50-metre swimmer, so maybe there is a chance to get him on the bike before the day is out.
There's hope for me yet.
So we have Scott Newstead taking that corner first. So both of these riders will progress through. However, there is money up for grabs, so I know that would be enough incentive for me to try and get across this line first. Who's going to take this corner first? So we have... So one is, they're drag racing. They're both neck and neck, actually. So we have Scott sliding into the front now.
So I guess here you just want to get through unscathed.
Definitely. That's number one priority, but if you can sneak that wheel across the line first, I would definitely be going for that. So we're another drag race down the back straight. Juan is going for it. This is the Colombia's national champion in swimming. Not sure what year that was in, but you can see that power. He got out and accelerated pretty quickly. He wanted to be first around that last corner. Scott is not giving up though. And they are both through.
Well done.
Juan takes it out.
Might have bought his own cheer squad here today too.
Yeah. I would definitely keep an eye on him for the next rounds. He's definitely got a bit of speed there, and he looks quite smart as well about where he uses that energy.
So they're the eight heats for the men, the four heats for the women coming up very shortly. Just before we get on to the women's heats, can we talk about a couple of the tactics and things we saw, Nettie, during those races? There were a couple of issues there in terms of the foot coming out of the pedal in one race. We had in another race, and of course, in the other race, we had some issues. What do you take on board there going forward? Is that the changing of the gears in the wrong gear? What do you do going forward from there? How do you make sure that doesn't happen again?
I think making sure that your bike is in top-notch condition. So straight away, make sure it's in the right gear when you're on the start line. I would put it in the big chain ring because you don't want to be changing that before the sprint. You don't want to cross chain as well, so that's you got to be careful about that. Just get your foot clipped in as soon as you can, settle in. And then, even down the back straight, depends on the race. If it's easy, like easier down the back straight, everyone's playing a bit of cat and mouse, I would still make sure that you've got it in the right gear for when you want to go. It's the same with bunch sprinting on the road. There's no point being in the wrong gear and then having to click whilst you're mid-sprint as your opposition will overtake and you might get some chain falling off or movement there. So definitely try and put it in the right gear before you need to perform.
Into the next round, and then of course towards the end of the day we have $5,000 worth of prize money up for grabs. Minister, just before we let you go, it's terrific to see the people of the Western Suburbs, the people of Adelaide come out, the people of Beverley here to support this terrific event. As we've got the Lions Club of Golden Grove here helping out, which is terrific, the people from Blackchrome. But not only here in the Western Suburbs, which you look after, but the fact that we are online at blackchrome.cc, people are watching the live streaming of that so far. Again, that's got to be great for our state.
Well, The weather is certainly turned on today. It's about 20 degrees too hot for me as a redhead, as I said already, but to be able to highlight this to all of those watching the live stream as well, as I said, I think shows just what we can do with innovating and coming up with new fantastic ideas which are community-led and small business-led through what's been a really, really tough year for business. COVID-19 has been a really... has had a marked effect on business in this state. I know that everyone is really thankful today to be able to be spending time here safely, but it also shows that in times of crisis and in times of great heartache, really fantastic things can come of it.
What about the push for South Australia to become more of a cycling state? That's something that certainly the political parties, to be fair, both are certainly pushing. It's a great thing for Adelaide, isn't it? We know the great cycling cities around the world and the great cycling countries, that Adelaide really is sort of putting a footprint on that in this country.
Look, 100%. Many people here today have probably followed in the last couple of weeks some of the hoo-ha around the investment the Adelaide City Council are making with making the Adelaide City more bike friendly. And sadly, some of the businesses along Flinders Street, I think it is, that are pushing back fairly hard against that. It's upsetting. Cycling is many things, but what it does is it finds a way for not only a down payment with well-being, a down payment with activity, but it also takes cars off our road. We are approaching, by any measure, a future where we need to do things differently when it comes to fossil fuels, with cars, with heat, and certainly with climate change. And the more we can jump on a bike and not rely on old technologies to get us around, the better.
The other thing too is we are lucky enough to have superstars in our midst in terms of Anna Mears and Annette Edmondson, and we also have, you know, the likes of Stuart O'Grady, but it's such a social sport, cycling.
Look, I've always wondered, I might have to ask a few people today about how you can actually chat when you're puffing along on one of those 150-kilometre rides. I look at some of these men and women riding around today and get puffed just having a look at it. So I'd love to hear about just how social it is. I do see everybody sitting around having the espresso and Chivo at the end of the ride. But COVID-19 has taught us about the importance of our mental well-being, and how sometimes isolation is the greatest enemy we've got, and the more we can do things together, the better.
So great to have you here. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon.
Great to be here, mate. Thank you.
Let's head to Annette Edmondson with Tim Decker, the head of Cycling Australia.
So we're here with Tim Decker. What do you think of this Blackchrome Velo GP?
Well, it's very short and fast, pretty exciting, and yeah, just waiting for someone to wash out on that bottom corner.
Well, so far so good. Where have you? What does it mean to have people support racing here in South Australia?
Yeah, look, this is a new event that obviously you've got up off the ground and proudly sponsored there by Blackchrome. But to get people out here and have a short, action-packed, different sort of sprint series on road bikes is pretty exciting.
Who do you think is going to win today? Have you had a look at the men's and the women's?
I've had a look at the men's, and I did have a look at the women's last night. I was looking on social media. I'm going for a Cal O'Brien Lee Howard in the men's, and who's in the women? I think
Chelsea. We have Nicola.
Nicola in the women's.
Alrighty, and then tell us about your program so far this year. What was it like having the postponement of the Olympic Games last year?
Yeah, look, tough, obviously, but tougher on the athletes than probably the staff, I would say. We've managed to get to this point, and we're pretty close now to our final build towards the Olympics. And, you know, it looks like either the Olympics will go ahead, which all indications are, or it'll be totally cancelled. But, yeah, the Olympics look like they're full steam ahead, and we're in that final build now of the last 16 weeks. So it's been tough to get to this point, but I think it's all on from here.
That's awesome. Where are you at with your prep at the moment? Have you been doing much racing, or I've heard there's some in-house trials been happening?
Yeah, there's some in-house rehearsals, not trials. We'll be trialling everyone at the games, won't we, to try and win gold. But no, we've been doing some in-house rehearsals, so we've been practicing different positions and different turn strategies, and getting ourselves ready for the Olympics so that we can go full bore from here in.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for coming down and supporting an event like this. It's great to have you here.
No worries. Thanks again.
This is what happens, Nettie, when you're speaking to the boss of Cycling Australia. We have the women's first heat. Nicola McDonald in the red, Annabelle Cox in the dark blue, and Shelby Johnson in the yellow.
Yes, a bit rusty on the old question asking at the start, but once you get started with Timmy, you can't stop. So we're ahead of schedule with the women. So Shelby Johnson took that the second corner in the lead. She's still sitting in first. We have Nicola moving up on the outside. So Nicola's gone into the front position, taking this corner first.
So one to go. And again, we should say too, Nicola, he'll be all great cyclists. Quality field here at the Blackchrome Velo GP.
So Nicola's still in the lead. She's a local bike rider. She used to ride for New South Wales, however she's moved here to be part of the track cycling program. So she was leading the Super Series for a while there on the road, and she's opened a big gap, so she's not taking any risks. She wants to be first, so we see her coming across the line. Second place, they've swapped positions. We've got Annabelle in front of Shelby. Bell take second place. So Shelby was in the front for a while there, but I think Annabelle rode that quite smart and saved some energy by sitting on the wheel. So she'll go through to the next round with Nicola also taking the prize money and moving through.
Well done. Heat two of the women's coming up very shortly. We're delighted to be joined by Clint Henry from the Tourism South Australia, the South Australian Tourism Commission. Clint, great to see you. Welcome aboard.
Thanks for having me.
So you are in the Department of Major Events. As we know, Hataf Rashid, yourself, the whole team do so much great work. This is an inaugural event, the first time we've seen it on the smaller stage, but hopefully there'll be more of this. You must be impressed.
Yeah. You know, running events in a COVID world are not easy at any time, and we get a lot of demand for these sort of cool, edgy events in the Tour Down Under and car park climbs and the like, and I think this would fit right in.
I might just happen to have one of the cycling superstars to my left with a little bit of an arm twist. Can we get an event like this in the Festival of Cycling next year?
Oh, I'd certainly think if Annette's got something to do with it, we might have some luck with that. But like I said, I think there's certainly demand for that come to the tour for this sort of thing. And, you know, there's a lot of programming opportunities. So, yeah, I think it'd be great.
I like that answer.
Can I just say, and again, maybe to you, Clint, more so than Annette, who's always been in the sport, but can you imagine where South Australia and Adelaide has gone in terms of a cycling hub since, you know, the money and the idea and the effort that went into the Santos Tour Down Under, for it to go from where it started with Mike, year one, Stuart wins it, to where we are now? I mean, you got through COVID. We know that it'll get back to normal, fingers crossed, next year. I mean, you must just be amazed at how much this sport has grown.
Yeah, we felt even this year when the Tour Down Under was cancelled that we had an obligation to the community of cycling to get something up. Hence, we pushed on with the Santos Festival of Cycling. You know, January in cycling is synonymous around the world. Everyone looks to Adelaide, and I mean, even this year, one of the highlights for us as an internal group is seeing people like Luke Platt come to fruition on the world stage, and hopefully that, you know, is the start of a world career for him.
Have you noticed that too, when you started the sport compared to where you are now at your elite level?
Absolutely. To go out to Harndorf and watch the men's tour come through back in the day, back when it wasn't World Tour, and then there wasn't even a race for women. So now that has been up and running and is so successful, it's so exciting. And to know that we have people like the SA Sports Commission behind us and wanting to make sure that sport goes ahead and keep that spirit of the community alive, it means a lot for our sport.
Clint, stay with us. We'll talk. And this is heat two. So we have Madeline Steele in the red. We have Kirsty Bull in the blue and Isabella Dashhorst in the yellow.
So we have Madeline Steele in the red. She is three-time Australian University champion, a stage winner in the SA Super Series 2016, and the conference road champion, South Central USA. So I know she did spend some time over in USA learning how to race crits. So we'll see if that comes into play today. She took that corner on the inside and overtook and moved into the first. So you can see she has got the bike handling skills. She is in front of Isabella. And then we have Kirsty dropping back a little bit, so that we have two in the front, so whether Kirsty can close that gap. She's got 1.5 laps to do so we'll see. So Maddie Steele's taking this corner first. Once again, she's on a Cervelo S3, super fast. Not a bad paint job. So we have a bit of a gap opening to Isabella.
Where on this track, Nettie, are you catching up, or where are you being found out if you can't quite stay with the leaders?
I think the important part is to come out of the corner with speed. So you can, if you're running at a wheel, coming into it and coming out with speed, but you don't want to be going into it, braking, and then having to do a standing start out of the corner because that uses up too much energy. So we've got lots of gaps here. We have Maddie Steele looking like she's this out. Isabella is coming in second, so they will both progress. Well done, Maddie, taking home the prize money for that round. And then we have Kirsty coming through now.
So that was heat two. Heat three about to start very shortly. So, Clint, back to you from a Tourism South Australia point of view and a major events point of view. I mean, we know the major events that we get. We see the Adelaide Oval used, and we've seen that for various sports. We know the big events. I know Tasting Australia is coming up, and that's massive. We have, as we mentioned before, the Santos Tour Down Under. The importance of an event like this in its first year to build, how do we make events like these become part of the calendar each and every year? What can the organisers do? What can riders do? What can the spectators do?
Yeah, well, I think the first thing you need to do when you run any event is make sure it's good. And, you know, turning up here today, not knowing what to expect, the guys have done a fantastic job. I think once you do a job, you then attract the talent. And, you know, again, great events rely on the talent to pull the crowds in. But I think when it's all said and done, the community need to get behind it. And if the crowds are turning up, then, you know, that attracts sponsorship and commercial dollars and, you know, it all just sort of self-fulfills itself. So I think they're on the right track.
Do you think an event like this, Nettie, is good for the sport in terms of something different? I mean, your eyes lit up when you first walked here because we haven't seen, I guess, what we're calling the teardrop type corner. We know the hot dog races that are sort of up and down, but something a little different in a suburban street on a beautiful Sunday afternoon.
Definitely. I'm all for change and for something different, and I feel like this type of racing suits everybody. It suits short distance riders, long distance, track, road, and I think a lot of people own road bikes, not as many people track or BMX or cyclocross. So I think that more people get on road bikes, so this could appeal to a lot more. And just to see short, fast, as for T20 style, it just keeps everybody interested. This is obviously a bit of a trial, so we have got a bit of time between the heats, so I'm sure we'll look at that, but we just didn't know what to expect. So we have heat three coming out now of the ladies, so yeah, it's all part of learning for next year, and I'm excited that this is already such a great event.
Clint, just before this race starts, is that something you notice at the SATC, that people want punchy events? You know, like it's attention span, the quicker, the more varied, the different, the better?
Yeah, I think, generally if we analyse the trends of events, and it's no surprise that the shortened version of most things are quite popular. So, I think it's a trend that will continue, everyone's time poor. I think certainly something that's popular with people.
So this is heat three of the women. Heather May in the red, Natalie Sesford in the blue, and Nicole Mitzi Georges in the yellow.
So Nicole raced in the Santos Women's Tour this year, and Heather May in the red hat, she used to be a track sprinter. So she rode for South Australia at the National Championships, and she's won national titles and Oceania titles on the track. And has apparently been playing rugby as of late. So I'd watch out for her turn of speed at the end. I reckon her tactic's going to be to sit in a bit, hope that the gap doesn't get too big in front, and then come through with some speed. But Natalie has gone out strong, and she's opened up a big gap. We've got Nicole trying to close it down the back straight. Heather sitting comfortably on the wheel. Remember, two go through, so the first takes the prize money, but two go through. So Heather still has a shot at this if she plays it carefully. So Natalie punches out. She's got a big gap, but there's still a whole lap to go. Can they close that gap in time?
Nettie, this could be one of those races within a race, isn't it, between Natalie and Heather here to get that second spot?
Absolutely, but I wouldn't say that it's all over yet. There's still a long straight, and it looks like Natalie has gone out pretty hard. She's moving around a bit, but we've got Nicole coming at her. She's actually put a gap between her and Heather May, so that actually surprised me. But I guess if you're going to rugby, then it makes it hard to ride as fast on a bike. She nods. So we have, wow, Natalie held on. Great work. Cole coming in second. And we have Heather May rolling through. Yeah.
Heather telling us she's had fun along the way, which is great. And again, at the end of the day too, with an event like this, being the inaugural event, not only do you want the spectator to love it, but cyclists too. So.
Absolutely. You never know what's going to happen out here, so you've got to be in it to win it. Give it a crack. See what happens.
Before we get on to Heat 4, can you talk about the physicality of a sport like this? What, for those of us who may be novices to cycling or watching for the first time, some of the people that have come to enjoy this, but also the people involved in the sport too, where is your main power coming from? What kind of exercises, what kind of diet are you looking at to have this kind of explosive, fast twitch fibre?
Well, as a cyclist, a lot of the power will come from the thighs and the glutes. So we often do a lot of cross training to help strengthen us for the road and the track. That means a lot of squats in the gym, a lot of lifts, grab bar deadlifts, throwing of the leg press, so short powerful things. Our track sprinters do a lot of explosive plyometrics, running upstairs or jumps. Anything powerful, short. Sometimes, depending on what time of the season it is, you can reduce the reps and just go for quality. And then in regards to nutrition, you've got to fuel up really well beforehand because your body is going to charge through those calories. So lots of carb loading before the sessions. Make sure you have big recovery between each rep so you can get the most out of it. And then fuel up on protein afterwards to make sure those muscles repair and get ready for the next day.
I think Anamias describes it as the beauty of the booty. You just put all the power in the back if you can. Well, I am seeing a little combination here, Clint, with cycling and Tasting Australia. Because Nettie just mentioned you need a big carb load. You can do that at TA. You need, what do you need? Proteins and meats at the end? I mean, that's
got... Definitely.
Get Nettie down in the village to just rip through some of Chong Lu's steak.
Oh, I think Nettie missed the San Remo piece of the pasta, but other than that, yes, we could definitely accommodate for that. I think Simon Ryan would love to whip up a big pasta dish for Nettie.
Sounds good. I'm all about that carb.
So here we are in Heat 4. Now we have just the two in this race. It appears as though Chelsea's not in this race. So this is Christine Page in the red. And Matea Palumbo in the light blue.
Well, there's a big upset. I thought Chelsea was one. She's not going to go home with any cash in her pocket because she hasn't lined up this morning. But this means that these two will go through. However, the race will be on for who gets to take home prize money for this heat. All right, so they're taking it pretty cruisy. No one wants to use up too much effort and energy unnecessarily because they've got finals to go through. But we've got one lap to go, so it's all going to be on next lap.
And so Matea's got the bandages already. I hope she's okay. But I guess what this means too, Nettie, is that you want to get in the next heat when you get to go through. I guess if you finish first or second depends on which side of the draw you'll go, so that might open up for you in the next heat.
Yeah, so if you've been paying attention to who's gone through the next rounds, depends on which position you want to finish in, but to be honest, if there's money up for grabs, I'll probably be trying to finish first.
I think the competitive juices would flow too, and if you can win it,
yeah,
will.
Definitely. You don't enter a bike race to come second. So Matei, she hits that corner. Oh, and we've got a late run from Christine, but Matei will go through. Actually, they'll both go through.
So the men's heat's coming up shortly. As we know, the rider's already through in the first initial eight. Hey, Clint, while we've got some moments here before the riders come out, this is a free kick for you. Tell us what the people here at Beverly, and tell us what the people watching on blackchrome.cc, the live stream which we hope you're enjoying, what should we be looking out for the Tourism Commission? What's coming to Adelaide that we all need to be a part of if we're not already? What's got your focus?
Well, we have Tasting Australia presented by REA Travel coming up in about 4 weeks from now. If you're into your food and wine, then that is not to be missed. There's some amazing chef talent. There's just an absolute bevy of wine talent on that programming this year. And it's fair to say, if you do want to go, you want to be quick, because I think about 95% of all tickets have been sold. So that's coming up shortly. It's exciting. We have one of our sponsored events, Illuminate, coming up in winter, which is the new lighting festival for the city, which is something new for the state, and that'll be exciting.
So is that similar to what we saw in North Terrace, where they led the museum and the universities? Is it that kind of thing?
Yeah, but probably just taking it to the next level. So thinking more like Vivid in Sydney and events like that. So
First year of that?
Yeah, first time, first year. And a couple of the creative directors behind that are very talented. So that's coming up for everyone in winter.
Fantastic. So the men lining up here for their heat. Look at the effort of Annette just going into the middle there, just making sure we get. So again, four riders in this race, but only two go through. And there is good pace on early.
So we have Harry going out early. He went on the front from the entire first straight. He's got Lee Howard on his wheel. Lee was not caught napping. He knew what was coming. So Lee has got a perfect sit right now. He's sitting on, Harry's doing all of the work. Lee just has to sit there and he can get dragged through. Top two go through, back two eliminated. So this gap is big. I don't know if these guys have got enough in it to close it by the end. We've only got three quarters of a lap to go. Lee is looking pretty, sitting there, looking around, making sure those other two are not coming home. Harry's happy to stay on the front. He wants to get as big as possible. He doesn't mind if Lee comes with him. Lee isn't going to sit there. I'm surprised. I thought he was going to leave it as late as possible. So Lee Howard's going to take this corner as first. He's got a gap, but Harry has got a big enough gap that if he can make it around, if he can make it around this corner, he will move through. And as you see, he's made it work.
Nettie, there was a distinct change in gears in that race. That was a lot faster, as you would expect, but that was blistering pace.
Yeah, you can see also with four riders, it gets a lot more complicated. So I did like the tactic of Harry there. He wanted to split it up. He wanted to make sure that only two went through and he was one of them. Having that gap there, it was worth keeping that gap, keeping the pressure on. Lee played it pretty well, sat in there, recovered as much as he could, and then hit out at the last minute. So it'll be interesting to see what the tactics are for the next few heats going forward as the standard gets better and better.
So heat 10 coming up very shortly in the men's section here. When you're watching it on blackchrome.cc or indeed you're here at the event here in Beverly. Joined by Clint Hendry from Tourism SA, just as we're about to get the boys ready for the next heat. Tour Down Under, circa 2022. Can you green light it or are you waiting on SA Health and the Police Commissioner and the Premier?
Certainly can't green light it for you, Leith, but I think it's very fair to say that everyone wants the Santos Tour Down Under back in its full form next year, and that's certainly what we're fairly committed to bringing, but with everything with this pandemic, it's subject to a lot of things, and the support of SA Health's been amazing through delivering the pageant at Adelaide Oval and, you know, all this, even the Festival of Cycling this year. So I think everyone's collaborative and wants to make it happen and work together, but there's just so many moving parts. But at this stage, that's what we're shooting for.
Just twist Dewey's arm, see if you can get a stage starting from Beverly, just out the front of Blackchrome. I could be happy with that.
Well, Stewie's probably one of the most seasoned race directors in the world, and he hasn't actually run a World Tour race yet. He learned more in his first 12 months than you could ever learn, but I'm sure Beverly would be a lovely start for a stage.
So here we go with heat 10 of the men's. And again, the pace is on.
So Josh Blake in McCullough, he is on the front. They've gone out pretty hard from the gun. The track sprinter. Dave Miller, the track sprinter, is in the yellow. So he's sitting in third wheel here, trying to make sure there's no gap opening and he can recover as much as possible. In the blue, we have Matt Fox sitting in second. And on the back is Glenn Nobes. So who's gonna go around this corner first? Glenn Nobes moves up a position into third. Dave Miller happy to be on the back. Is this a tactical decision? Josh Blake still on the front, with Matt Box tucked in behind, getting a good sit, looking back, making sure no one's making any attack over the top. So Josh Blake still on the front. He doesn't want to go behind anybody else. He's in control. Matt Box has made a big move. He's going with one, well, it was three quarters of a lap to go down the back straight. So he's made it around that corner with speed. Oh no. Maybe too much speed in that one. Dave Miller coming across. So Josh Blake will take that out after leading for a long time. But that one's definitely gonna hurt for Matt. He went around there pretty quick, so it might be a road rash. Such a shame, because that was a really good move. He went with so much speed down that back straight, but it's always a risk if you hit that corner with too much speed. So good on you for having a crack. Good to see him back up on his bike riding. That's a shame to see him knocked out, because he would have made it an exciting final. So Dave Miller managed to sneak through in that one too. As you could say, almost not a Stephen Bradbury, but he was lucky because he would have been third across the line. So he's going to be into the finals. Oh, no, the semi-finals.
Can you walk us through what would have happened there? So you're going too fast around the corner. Do you know, is that a wheel issue? Is that a balance issue?
Could be any of the above. Yeah, so it's all, yeah. It all depends on the speed, the angle, your tyres, your tyre pressure, when you put the power down coming out of the corner. One of my teammates crashed in the National Criterium Champs only a couple of months ago because she put the power down too early, and it was an off-camber corner, potholes. So there's so much can happen. There's so many question marks, and I think that's what she thinks she's done, but she's not sure. It could have been, there's a slight crosswind, so it could have been a little bit of a gust at the same time. So there's a lot of factors. So hopefully he knows what it was, because I find if you go down hard, it's always nice to have a reason, because then you can sit with it more comfortably. But if you have no idea, then it does leave you a bit unnerved moving forward.
So even Clint and I winced, and we're fine. So if you've had a fall, what do you do as a rider? Does it kick in straight away, or is the adrenaline flowing that much that it's not till you get back and you'll cool down? That's when it really hits you.
Well, that type of burn hurts instantly, so he'll be stinging. But then once you get on the bike, you do get that a bit of adrenaline, so he'll be okay for a bit. He'll spin it down, but then I think once he gets off the bike and sits down for a little bit, then he's going to stiffen up, and that's when it's going to hurt. And then waking up tomorrow, he's going to be really stiff. So whether he gets a bit of whiplash as well, it's not nice.
Let's hope there's no speaker anywhere near where he is at the minute.
You also check your bike though, Leith, just to make sure it's not too badly damaged.
So this is heat 11, or the third of the quarters, if you like. So we've got Kent, Matt, Phil, and Scott in this one. Kel in the red.
Yeah, so Kel O'Brien in the red. Matt Miller in the dark blue. We have Phil Crick in yellow, and Scott Newstead in the light blue.
Just as they're around the corner safely.
Matt Miller on the front. He's got a GoPro across his chest. Keep filming the action. Kel O'Brien sitting tucked in pretty comfortably on the wheel. Similar to the first round, Lee Howard sitting on. So Kel went around that corner first on the inside. Matt Miller going hard up the outside, takes the front again, doesn't want to be in second position. This is turning out very similar to the round before. Kel O'Brien sitting in second. And we've got a bit of a gap to Phil Crick and then Scott Newstead on the back. So two go through, two eliminated. It looks like Matt's looking around a bit. Is he going to continue with this move, or is he going to let the others get back on? Does he have enough energy to keep going? Kel O'Brien looking around. He wants to go around that corner first. So Kel's around the corner first. Matt still in second, but it looks like they've come together. That little bit of hesitation was enough to close the gap. Kel O'Brien's off. He's had enough. He's going to go around that corner first. So Matt Miller in second. Is there enough time for Phil to come through? Ooh, it's getting close. So Kel O'Brien will take that prize money. And after a big ride from Matt Miller, he'll move through in second.
Wide turn there. Just ended up in someone's backyard.
Yeah, it's the last corner. People are fatigued. It's hard to, all of a sudden your skills are a lot harder to perform when you're under fatigue. So this is when the accidents start to happen at the end of bike races. But they all got through nice and safely, so.
Clint, thank you for joining us. Continue the great work that Events SA are doing, that the South Australian Tourism Commission are doing. If you could please take to a TAF the idea of Nettie Edmondson running kind of a half cycling, half food combo, carbo load and protein, with, followed by a quick ride, I think the people would flock to it.
I think I'd have to roll out of the venue after all this carbs and protein. Wouldn't be complaining at the time, though.
Where's the best place for people to go to keep up to date with all the events?
Best place to go would probably be to the relevant website for each event, which can all be found on the Tourism Commission website if you want to go there to start. But yeah, pretty much everything's there.
Tastingaustralia.com.au, what's your choice? Nettie, you want to go and get some Coffin Bay oysters straight out of the water? Or go down to Millicent and have the Mayura steak, the Wagyu steak, for about $600 a kilo?
All of the above, now that my microphone decides to work. But no, great
to see
you.
Thanks
for joining us. Thanks for having me,
guys. Enjoy the afternoon. Heat 12, very shortly, the fourth of the quarterfinals.
Yeah, so good to see so many events happening and taking place despite a really challenging year. And thanks to people like Clint at the SA's at Events South Australia, mental blank. We're thankful to have so many things up and running and so successful. So we have Willis Lionheart in the yellow. We have Juan Molina in the blue, the Colombian national champion swimmer. Matt Franks is in the red, so he's gone around that corner first. He's taken this on with both hands. Still half a lap to go. So Matt Franks is on the front. He'll likely go through to the next round. Willis in hot pursuit in second.
Here we go, last lap. Oh.
So Juan Molina has decided to go. He was in third, but the gap opened up too quickly. So now he's had to go at the last minute. But is that gap too big for him to make it back across the line in second or first? All he needs to do is make it to second to go through to the next round. You can see him coming with speed, but I feel like Matt Frank has got too much.
And
Willis is straight on that wheel too. So I think those two are going to be going straight through to the next round. Yeah, it's a tactical game too, this one. You can't sit there and wait. It's all over too quickly if you're not ready.
Well done.
Create your own unique cycling kit with Blackchrome's Kit Creator, the easiest way to design on mobile, tablet or PC. First, select your fit, then select a product. Edit colours from our huge colour range. Next, you can add graphics from our library. Scale, edit and change colours. Add custom text and your team logos. Create designs across additional products to complete your kit. Kit up and ride with Blackchrome.
So I hope you're enjoying all the action of the Velo GP this afternoon, joined by a man who would be prouder than most, I would have thought, because Mark Bassett, this is your baby. Are you like the proud father seeing this event come from, I guess, a germ of an idea to what we have today?
Oh, just ecstatic with what's happening here today, Leith. Yeah, look, 6 months ago when COVID hit and, you know, shut down cycling and shut down sport, we just thought, you know, what can we do when we come out of COVID? And we wanted to do something spectacular, something that was different, you know, a totally different racing format. And we started thinking about it, and here we are today with this, you know, type of Velo Grand Prix, as we have termed this type of race.
So like the song, from little things, big things grow. Did you envisage what we've seen today?
Not at all, not like this, no. But this is just, you know, fantastic what's going on here. You know, there's a good crowd, some quality riders. So this is the inaugural event. And, you know, it's in our front yard, if you like, where Blackchrome is based here in South Australia, in Beverley. But we want to, you know, take this bigger and better. And, you know, but today is, you know, a learning experience for us. But I am totally wrapped with what's happening here today.
I'll get on to Blackchrome in just one second. But first, talk to me about what it's been like putting an event like this together, because not only do you want the spectators to enjoy it, but at the end of the day, you want the cyclists to have fun. We've seen thrilling entertainment and excitement here so far. So if the riders love it, they'll continue to come, and then it builds.
Now, look, first and foremost, we're eager to get feedback from the riders. We want this to be, you know, a fantastic experience and day, you know, for riders. So for me particularly, I want to learn a lot about that and what can we do to make it bigger and better. But we also wanted something, you know, this short, fast racing, you know, some power involved, some technical aspect to it. We're trialling it here, you know, on this day here. But we want to take it further.
We've been saying during the call, it's a bit like the T20 of cycling because it is fast, it is furious, the two go through, two miss out, and as we know, the heats just continue to go through, which is, it's been so much fun so far. We can't wait to see what happens in the final. Talk to us about Blackchrome itself, because you, as I said, you created the idea, you come up with the germ of the idea. Tell us about your business.
So Blackchrome, you know, we're a sportswear business. I started this business about 19 years ago, and in the last 7 to 8 years, we've ventured across into cycling apparel, and we've got, you know, Travis Eddy on board, who's really driving our cycling apparel business. But we're a multi-sport, you know, we're involved in sportswear and other sports, at, you know, grassroots level. We're national, 70% of our business is interstate. We're proud to be a South Australian business, but you know, we're here today because we really want to do something for cycling and the cycling community, and you know, it starts off here today in Beverley's.
Got a lot of heavy hitters here too. We've spoken to ministers, we've spoken to people from the Tourism Commission. How great would it be if you could get this Velo GP, the Blackchrome Velo GP, part of the Festival of Cycling, part of the Santos Tour Down Under?
Oh look, you got to have dreams, don't you? So yeah. TDU, if we can be there and do something there, you know, that would be awesome. But, you know, we just want to do one day at a time. We're here today. We really want to listen and learn from the riders that are here today and get feedback, and, you know, we'll take it from there.
All right, here's your pitch. You've got a big crowd out there. You've got a bigger crowd online. Blackchrome.cc, people watching the live stream. Hope they're enjoying it. If you're a sporting organisation, I guess big or small, doesn't matter what sport, doesn't matter where you are in this great country of ours, you can get kitted out from Blackchrome.
Absolutely. So, yeah, whatever sport you're in, that's what we do. And, yeah, but today's about cycling for us, yeah, and the cycling community.
All right. There you go, cyclists. And those who love the sport, make sure you get in touch. Congratulations on the day. It's been a great success so far. Can't wait to see the thrilling finals. And so far, so good in terms of injuries. We haven't had any, so that's good.
No, there's one spill. So I hope that guy, Matt Fox, I think his name is. So I hope he's okay. But looking forward to the finals in both the men's and the women's. Yeah.
I should say, too, remiss of me before we go, I noticed you've got one of the sponsors' products just there. These events can't happen without help, can they?
No, you always got to have a beer, whatever you do. So Little Bang Brewery, thank you.
Well done. And to all the sponsors who have been part of it today, thank you so much for your continued support. Mark Bassett, thanks so much. No rest for the wicked. Nettie, we're about to go with the ladies.
Five seconds. All right, so we have Nicola McDonald in the red. Phil is in the dark. Nicole is in the yellow, so she's got the fluoro. And Christine Page is the teal on the back. So Nicole has taken this on. She's doing all the work on the front. Maddie Steele, that smart bike rider I spoke about earlier, she's from the U.S. Well, she did some racing over in the USA, so she has a tactical head on her. So she's sitting in second. So we have Maddie Steele, she's on the front now. Nicola sitting pretty in second. She looks pretty relaxed as she looks over her shoulder. It's the Georges is sitting in third with the yellow cap. The race is still on. Only two people will go through. We've got one lap to go. Oh, Nicole went hard from the gun, but she's now in third. So I'm not sure if she's got the legs to close that gap. There's only two going through, remember. Nicola McDonald decides she wants to go around that corner first. So she's overtaken Maddie Steele. Maddie Steele in second. That gap is getting bigger to Nicole, so I'm not sure if she's going to have the legs to make it into the finals. Nicola looks pretty cruisy there as she goes through that corner. Steele sitting in second. She will go to the finals. Although it's not over till it's over, we've already seen a few people out of that. She comes through safely. That's Nicola McDonald through and Maddie Steele in second. With Nicole Burgess in third, Christine Page bringing home in fourth.
Well done, ladies. So Nicole and Maddie go through to the final. We have one more heat, which will get us our other two riders for the final here at the Blackchrome Velo Grand Prix. Interesting to hear the fact that we're so close to the action, Nettie. You can hear people on the sides giving commentary, suggestions, I guess. That helps the riders. I mean, they know what they're doing, obviously, but it would be nice to hear that support.
Yeah, definitely. Getting behind people makes such a big difference when you're out there. Sometimes it depends on what type of race it is, but if you've got a bit of, if there's a bit of a lull in the action, sometimes it's good just to hear a little bit of a tip to keep you switched on from your coach or from somebody you know. It's funny, you can pick out the voices very easily without looking or thinking about it, so definitely helps having people cheering out there.
Are you someone in the zone? Are you someone who's in the zone that you can't hear anything, or are you someone that takes bits and pieces of what's going on around you?
I think it depends what race, but when you're out on the track in the velodrome and you've got people cheering for you, it's an absolute roar when it bounces off the roofs. And I definitely think that I can hear a lot more than I probably should. I probably should pay attention to what I'm doing rather than who's out there in the crowd cheering. But the thing is, it's like depends. Sometimes you can use it to your advantage. Even if we had to do some big races over in Britain, and when you've got major rivals on the other side of the track, you just got to pretend that they're cheering for you and not let it get to you mentally.
Because whilst I'm not an elite athlete, I did host the Eclipse of 500 concert, and I heard every bit of abuse, which was interesting, from the crowd of 30,000. Hey, the Copper Coast 2021 SA Masters Games is on from the 15th until the 18th of April. If you're interested in participating, what an event this will be at the Copper Coast, the Masters Games. You can do it as an individual or as a team. You can just visit at coppercoast.sa.gov.au. And you'll get all the latest updates with the event there. The cycling is from the 16th on the Friday right through to Sunday, the 18th of April. So SA Masters Games, great to see so many people taking part. Beautiful part of the world, the Copper Coast, April 15 to 18.
So here we are on the semi-final number two. So we have Natalie Sesford in the dark blue, Matei Palombo in the red, Annabelle Cox, she's in the yellow, and Izzy Dashhorst is in the teal. So in the teal on the front is Izzy. Natalie Sesford tucked in second. I think second would be my ideal position. I feel like you've got a bit of recovery from the one in front because of the aerodynamics, but you've also got a chance to look behind and make sure that you stay in the front of the action.
So if you are second, when and where are you going try and jag first?
I think based on the races before, I would probably go down the back straight, leave it last minute with about 3/4 of a lap to go. So you can see Natalie's sitting in there, tucked in, getting aerodynamic advantage. Yep. So both the top two will go through to the final. They've got a big gap here. Matei Palombo working hard to close it. She comes from triathlon, so I wonder if after this race she'll decide to choose more road cycling. She's done really well to get to the semis. But there's two out the front, they've got a big gap. We've got Natalie in the dark blue. She's in second at the moment. Izzy Dashhorst is in the lead. But they're drag racing it into this final corner. They both want to make it through. There's still money up for grabs for the win of this round, even though they both go through.
Oh, takes her on the inside. Well done.
Natalie Sesford. She's going to come across the line first.
Well done.
First one through to the final. Big ride there from Izzy to come through as well. And Matei in third. And Annabelle Cox from Clare. She's also a vet, rounding out the top four.
So that was a fascinating final turn there, the corner, the last corner. Do you go on the outside? Do you go on the inside? She just got it just at the end.
Yeah, it's interesting to know, well, just to kind of gauge by the riders in front, just to see how much work they've done. If they've done too much work, then there's always that little chance that you could sneak back through. So it's not over till it's over. There's famous footage on YouTube of people who salute too soon and then get rolled. So I'd always try to make sure I go across the line first before putting those hands up if you think you've won it. And even perhaps if you don't know, then don't throw your hands in the air at all. It's quite embarrassing.
Where does the lactic acid kick in, do you think, on this road? Where are the riders feeling it the most?
Depends what tactic you go out with. So if you go out hard from the gun and you try and get a gap, you're going to be pumping through that lactic acid. But if you decide to stop with that attack, then you're going to be having to deal with it whilst you're still out on the course, whilst other people have caught up. So you got to try not to think about it too much. I think elite sport is 95% mental. So you've chosen to do a tactic, you've just got to put up with it and think about the race in front of you and push through that pain and then deal with it afterwards.
Having dealt with elite athletes at the radio station now for a number of years, the fascinating part is what recovery has become. Whereas in the old days, recovery was a beer and a cigarette. Now, of course, elite athletes, it's all about ice baths and stretching, etc. What would the riders be doing today versus, I guess, what would you be doing in some of your events? What kind of way would you unwind?
Ride without limits with Blackchrome's complete range of custom cycling apparel. Quality kit to suit every rider. Perfect for a Ride without limits with Blackchrome's complete range of custom cycling apparel. Quality kit to suit every rider. Perfect for events, corporates, teams and social groups. Be prepared for all seasons. Transform your team with our online custom kit creator. Kit up and ride with Blackchrome.
To do it is to do hot cold, so you do 2 minutes on two in the hot, 2 minutes in the cold. So some people prefer the flush option, but I do prefer just 10 minutes of solid. And then some good food, get some good meals in, try and wind down. A lot of my races on the track are at night, so some of them are about 9 p.m. so it's quite hard to wind down, but we often take some caffeine, so we're alert, so I prefer just to take my time, wind down slowly, and go to bed when you're ready.
Hold that thought for 1 second. Matt Miller, if Matt can hear us. Matt, you're in the final. We need you to get to the riders' area, please. Matt Miller, if you could make your way to the riders' area for the final. We look forward to the men's coming up shortly. And that's great insight, Nitty, as to what you do to become the elite athlete that's had the incredible career that you've had. These kind of events that we hope everyone's enjoying, not only watching on blackchrome.cc, the live stream, but also the people who are here in the western suburbs of Adelaide in the suburb of Beverley here this afternoon. We do need to say thank you to a lot of people because so many people, speaking to Mark earlier about this, to be able to put this event on, obviously Blackchrome, but the sponsors that go with it, bikeshack.com.au, Fame and Spear, Physio Fit, City of Charles Sturt, Oz Cycling as well. But we'll get to some of the other people we need to thank, including our St. John's volunteers. Thank you for your work this afternoon. Thank you to the team from Cycling Australia, from VW Bars. Thank you so much to the Lions Club of Golden Grove. Hopefully there's still some snags left. Everyone here at Meyer Court, the neighbours here of Blackchrome, so thank you so much, including Millennium Couplings, the Chair Doctor, Home Care Equipment. Also want to thank the commissaires and the security guards for all the work that they've been able to do. We know that with COVID, any event is a great event, and we are underway in this.
All right, so in the red, we have Lee Howard. He's been red the whole time. So this is the semi, so top two go through to the final. We've got a fast start. Dark blue, we have Matt Franks. He's in blue, so he's gone hard from the start. In the colour light blue, Matt Miller. So the two Matts are out in front, followed by Lee, and then Willis Liner in yellow on the back at the moment. They've gone really hard. Now that gap is starting to open on the front. Can he make it wider? Lee sensing some issues here, some trouble out the front, so he doesn't want to be too far back, so he's moving up. Will he go around the corner first? Yep, straight up the inside. Wow, they're going too wide around the corner. So Lee comes out. Still in the front, closing the gap, squeezing out Matt Miller. There's two Matts here, it's confusing. Yeah, Willis is on the back. So he's easy to spot in the yellow. Then we've got Lee still in the front. Matt Franks is holding second. Can he get past Lee again? Remember, top two go through to the finals. There's still money up for grabs, hence why Lee's going so hard. He's got a young daughter that he's got to look after now. So they've got had a very busy month. Wife Maria at home looking after her, I think. Well done, Leif. Matt Franks holding on to second. He had a big ride. Willis came through pretty well there. But Matt Miller coming fourth today. So that one was on. Lots of changing positions.
Once again, a lot of focus in there on that last turn here. Do you go wide? I guess you can't go too wide to the left and cut across to the right. People are on your inside. So it seems as though at the moment, if you can, you want to try and get that inside lane, I guess, at the right appropriate speed so that you don't create carnage for yourself and the others.
Yeah, the inside's better, but at the same time, it's slower. So you can keep more speed if you go a bit wider, but considering the way this corner works, it is pretty technical, and you will probably have to go into the inside, whereas that the tighter one down the other end, the hairpin, you often can keep a bit more speed if you go wider, so it depends. The National Crit Championships was on a hairpin corner like this at the other end, so my job was just to sprint, so my tactic was to try and reduce the amount of times I had to punch out of the saddle, so I wanted to keep as much speed as I could. So I was happy to not go around the corner first. I just kind of floated towards the back and kept as much speed as I could, kept as wide as I could. And after about an hour of racing, all those accelerations do add up. And so, yeah, if I, as a sprinter, saving that energy was a tactical choice.
How did you go in that crit, by the way, Nettie?
I won. I put my hands in the air. I was very, very excited to win that. I've had my eye on that for a long time. Been around for a while.
So here we go in the second of the semifinals.
Yeah, we are going to see the champion's jersey in the Super Series. Blackchrome Sportswear are making up a special edition. Very exciting. So we have the second semi-final here. So Kel O'Brien, the inform kit with the red helmet cover. We got David Miller in the light blue. Josh is on the front. He was first round the corner in the blue. And then we have Harry sitting in second in the yellow. So they've gone out. Kel was in fourth, but he's not happy with that. He's moving up into third. Will he go past them all? Yep, he's gone around on the front. Red helmet cover, now he's looking back. He doesn't want to go too hard too soon. Harry's moved up, he's sitting in second. Miller's now up, giving Kel a run for his money. He doesn't want to get caught behind. We've still got one more lap of racing, so this race has been on from the start. Dave Miller is going for it. He's got a bit of a gap. Kel looking over his shoulder, sitting in second. Harry sitting on his wheel. Who's going to have what it takes down this back straight into the last corner? Kel around the corner first, on the outside. Dave Miller on the inside. So Kel attacking up the inside. There's a drag race between Harry and Dave. Who's going to get around this corner first? Harry is sliding into second. The top two go through. Dave's not giving up. And here we are, Kel O'Brien taking the win and Harry making it through to the next round. Great ride from Harry. Dave Miller absolutely spent. Track sprinter on the road. That's a lot of lactic acid right there, so he's going to have to spin that out, otherwise he's not going to be moving very quickly from now on.
Maybe because you told us his CV at the start of this event, Kel the one to beat, do you think, in this men's race? He seems to just do it at the right time and has enough left.
Yeah, I'm not sure, but Lee has also had some very similar tactics. In that they sit into second wheel, have a crack, move up down the back straight. So I'm not sure what condition they're both in. They both had a few days off the bike. Oh, Lee says bad condition. He's in dad condition as well, might I add. So he's had to change a tyre. So we'll see how, if he's had enough sleep this week, if he's ready to take on Kel O'Brien.
What a unique event where, as you're riding, you can actually hear everything that the MCs are saying and can respond to you as they ride past.
Yeah, it's a little bit awkward. No, it's quite funny when you do hear your name getting called on the loudspeaker. I think it goes back to what we were speaking about before, where I often should be paying more attention, but sometimes, depending on where the speaker is, you can hear what people are saying about you. And, yeah, apparently you were in the crit the other day, because that's fresh in my mind. I sat at the back, so I was hitting a lot, and then I think the commentators finally realised I was still there. And then they started speaking about, is this a tactic or is she not feeling so good? So I was like, I'm feeling good, I swear.
You just want to respond. Now, you mentioned the jersey a short time ago, that we'll see that jersey this year.
Yep, so that is in the process of being made with a few of my sponsors on there. So we've got Thrive Healthcare, Clear Wipes, and we have Cervelo.
Can I tell you a story, and I won't out the person, but there was a well-known Adelaidean who loved their cycling but didn't really know the protocols with and just wanted to buy a kit to look nice on the road, and saw a kit at the shop and thought, that's a great jersey, I'll buy that and I'll wear that. Apparently it's not the dumb thing if you're not the world champion to wear the rainbow jersey and ride down Henley Beach Road or Grange Road.
Yeah, it's frowned upon. However, I feel like there's... So my opinion is, if you are a cyclist that competes, so whether it be a club race or professionally or states or whatever,
yep,
then you don't wear... If you know what that... Yeah, you wouldn't wear a world champion jersey on the road if you compete. However, if you are just a fan of the sport, you get out here every now and then, you enjoy riding your bike, then go for it. I feel it's pretty obvious to tell who is serious and who is not, and I don't think that we should slam the door on people who are just trying to support racing. So
he didn't know. He just liked the colours.
And that's okay.
And I won't mention Cornsey's name because he'd be embarrassed by that.
But yes, the rainbows are usually reserved for the world champions on the road.
Yep. He might have got a couple of eyebrow lifts on the way through.
It's technically, you're supposed to wear it in the discipline that you do. So if you're the crit champ, you can only wear the world, well, there's no world champs for the criterium, but it's saying the national champ, you can only wear it in the criterium. You can't wear it in a road race and vice versa.
So we have a door prize this afternoon. So hopefully everyone was able to get themselves an entry for this door prize. A terrific prize thanks to Blackchrome, $250. It entitles you to $250 off your next order of the collection, the cycling kit, the accessories. And we are happy to say that Carl Purcell has won the $250 Blackchrome door prize. Carl, are you here? If you are, Carl, come on down to the VIP section. You can pick up your prize. You might get something a little extra in there as well, an added extra. But thank you again to everyone for coming here to the beautiful western suburbs of Adelaide for this event today here in Beverley. And we hope for those people who are watching the live stream on the website blackchrome.cc that you've enjoyed the coverage so far. We have the main races on the way, the men's final, the women's final, not too far away. And again, $5,000 up for grabs throughout the day with prize money. So well worth the effort for all of the riders who are here this afternoon. We asked one of the riders if they wanted to come and say hello. He was too stuffed, Nettie, to say hello. So we'll find out how the riders are facing and how they're finding this course. That's right, they might be dealing with the lactic acid.
We have the ladies lining up for the big grand final. So we have Nicola McDonald in the red. We have Maddie Steele in the yellow. So we had a confusion between the blue helmets. So Izzy is in the light blue on the back. We have Natalie Sesford in the dark blue. Maddie Steele is on the front in the yellow. So she's gone out hard. I would have thought she would have done a different tactic. So this might have caught other people napping. They might not have been expecting this. Nicola is sitting in third in the red helmet. Natalie Sesford is doing the chasing, but Nicola's moved forward. She doesn't really caught too far back. Izzy Dash Horse, she's a tandem pilot on the track. So she's sitting in fourth. There's still one lap to go, so there's still time to move up. Maddie Steele on the front, driving it down the front straight. Nicola sitting pretty on her wheel. Nicola wants to win. There's $500 up for grabs today if you take this out. So a big prize bucket. There's money down to third. Nicola takes that corner first. We've got a bit of a gap to Maddie Steele. She just did a lot of the work, so whether she can hold on to second or bring it home. Nicola is opening up that gap. So still one last tight corner to go. Nicola in front, Maddie Steele in second. We've got Natalie Sesford in third and Izzy in fourth. And that's how they will finish. Natalie Sesford third, and Izzy in fourth. So congratulations to Nicola McDonald, South Australian, once New South Wales, but now the good old South Aussie. She's come to the right place. So she used her race smarts to sit on, save a bit of energy, and attacked when it mattered. She held off the competition. Maddie Steele went out early. I'm not sure if that, I think that was a tactical move. She knows how to ride, so she's obviously planned that out from the gun. So she went out, used a bit of energy. Nicola had the legs. Maddie came in second, and we had Natalie finishing up in third.
So $500 going to the first place rider in Nicola, who might have given you a little sneaky wink at the start line. She was pretty confident, I think, going into 250 for the second place, 100 for third, and the fourth place will take home $50. So well done to the ladies, a cracking final. Let's hope the men's is equally as exciting.
Awesome, and all the ladies kept it up. I'd like to have a quick shout out to all of them. Good on you. Raced smart, raced well, and held it up. So hope you enjoyed racing out here today, and hope you all sign up for next year. Hopefully it'll be even bigger and better. But still, racing is not over. We have the men's final coming up soon. We have the two track boys, Lee Howard, Kel O'Brien, versus the two road boys, Harry Holloway and Matt Franks. Who will come out on top?
Is there any chance that, as we know, we're waiting to see what happens with the Olympics this year, but is there any chance that, well, I don't know, let's say an Adelaide Commonwealth Olympic World Champ Superstar might have a crack at this event next year?
With this type of money up for grabs, I mean, why wouldn't you? I mean, this is my first time trying to talk on the microphone, so I feel like it's actually easier to ride a bike, to be honest. So sorry for all the mistakes and the slow stuff that I'm doing, but we're trying. We have a special guest here today. We have Heather May, South Aussie track sprinter, now dabbling rugby?
Rugby.
Wow, that's cool. How long have you been playing rugby for?
I started last year, just because with cycling, everything I both, because, you know, injuries and everything. But, you know, it's been fun doing something different that's not bikes.
And are you still keeping up the similar sort of training, or are you spending a bit more time doing the rugby?
I was doing the rugby last year, but I've now got Michelle Ferris as a coach, so trying to get back up to the level I was.
Create your own unique cycling kit with Blackchrome's Kit Creator, the easiest way to design on mobile, tablet or PC. First, select your fit, then select a product. Edit colours from our huge colour range. Next, you can add graphics from our library. Scale, edit and change colours. Add custom text and your team logos. Create designs across additional products to complete your kit. Kit up and ride with Blackchrome.
And following wheels and like can kind of cut under to like if you want to snake someone out of position. But no, it's good. Very technical, but very fun.
Heather, stay with us because the men's final is about to start here.
We have Lee Howard in the red helmet, Kel O'Brien in the dark blue, Harry Holloway is in the teal on the back, Matt Franks in the yellow. So Lee is on the front. He wants to make this hard. Harry in the black chrome colours. So Matt Franks has led every race out. He likes to go from the front. You can see him sitting in second wheel on Lee, so whether he'll try and get back up. But they look like the pace is on. Lee Howard, Kel O'Brien moving up on the inside. He also wants to be further forward. Ooh, that was pretty cozy. Two of them, ooh, Harry is down. He's getting up quickly, he's all right. Lee's keeping the pressure on, Kel's moving up. Matt Franks is going into third. Lee looking around. Lee Howard takes the corner first. We've got Kel O'Brien in second, a bit slower. Coming out, there's a bit of a gap in front of him. Who's gonna take out the win? Lee Howard still got a gap. Kel in second, big gap. And then we've got a big gap to Matt Franks in third. But it's between these two. Normally the one on the front comes out first. Will Kel get past in time? And it's come down to the line. We have Kel O'Brien in a photo finish from Lee Howard. Matt Franks in third, and Harry Holloway will finish in fourth after a slide out, but he'll still take home $50. Congrats, Kel O'Brien, $500. Lee Howard in second after a week with his newborn. Not bad, first race back. Great work, Harry. Well, there you go. What did you think about that?
It was amazing, wasn't it? Photo finish, but even Heather jumped out of her seat and said, I think Kel's got that one. So it was incredible pace, though, wasn't it, from the boys?
That was insane, like, just coming out and, like I said, snaked under. So I'm
yeah.
The wrong one who comes out first, crosses the line first.
Yeah, well, I felt like it was whoever went into that last corner would often win it if they went in first. So they proved us wrong, and Kel managed to get there in the end.
We appreciate you coming over. What does your year look like from here?
Well, just getting back into a cycling program as well as finishing off the rugby season, but then just fitting it in with uni and, you know, club events here and there.
And so what's it like with Michelle?
Well, I start like next week, so it's a very new coaching relationship. But yes.
So will she be coaching you from interstate, or has she moved to South Australia?
No, so interstate. So it'll be lots of Skypes and Zooms and checking in every week. So.
Wow, Michelle Ferris is a legend of the sport, so that is a very wise choice to be looked after by her, and I can imagine it's going to be a great partnership. So good luck.
Thank you.
We are looking at the photo here. Wowee.
Holy wow. There is 2 centimetres in it in the photo finish between Kel O'Brien and Lee Howard.
The thickness of the wheel.
That's pretty cool. Well done, boys. Do you want to see the photo? It was you, Kel. It's his long arm, says Lee. Wow, good on you, boys. Great job. Got through smoothly. Well, well, that's the first Blackchrome Velo GP done and dusted.
We will have the presentation very shortly and we'll speak to the winners shortly. That is a great Instagram photo, that one right there. This is the difference between first and second. As we see in, I guess, elite sport, how many times have we seen that kind of measurement sorting out first from second? Amazing.
Absolutely. And you said before about how elite sport is changing and how a lot of people are doing all the one percenters. And when you have races that come down to margins like that, it does actually make a difference doing the right thing. So making sure you have good recovery, making sure you're getting enough sleep, eating the right foods, getting that protein in after the sessions, carbs before. Just doing the right things will make those tiny milliseconds of a difference. And when races come down to that, it's so important.
Sakil can hear us, so maybe just adjust your answer to this. When you came around that last, did you think you could get it from second spot? Were you confident?
No. To be honest, I was not. I've been watching the series so far, and there's not been many that have overtaken if you haven't been first around that corner. And I do know that Kel likes to go around the corners first. He did in most of the corners in each of his heats. So I thought he'd resign to second, but like I said before, it's not over till it's over, and he didn't give up. So good on ya.
Once again, the beauty of being so close to the riders, you can hear everything we said, which is great. Well, it's been a terrific event so far. Thank you to everyone for coming out. Hope you've enjoyed it. Hope you can stick around too for the presentations, which are about to happen here. The staging boys just doing some work. Bloke on the end looks like he's struggling. He's had a big day. But it's been terrific. We hope too, if you've been watching it on blackchrome.cc, you've enjoyed the coverage too. And again, we should congratulate everyone that's been involved in the coverage, Nettie, because to be able to witness an event of this quality and to be able to do it, I mean, the days you would have had to have been here, but the beauty of technology now is that it doesn't matter where you are around the country or the globe, you can tune in and watch elite sport at its finest.
Because the guy was behind.
Ken Murray back.
Yeah.
strip the interview cam. Oh, too late.
Get one leg, that back leg, and get out. No, leave them up. Just get them out.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, hope you've had a great day here. Thank you so much again for coming to the Blackchrome Velo GP. Hope you've enjoyed being part of it today. Hope you'll be back next year. And hopefully when Clint comes across to present some of these, we'll actually get a part of the cycling festival next year at the Santos Tour Down Under. Clint Hendry from SATC is going to come across. Clint, come across if you can, please. And we'll present our fourth to first winners. Cycling superstar Annette Edmondson is on her way too to present the checks as well. In fourth place, had an amazing afternoon, Isabella Dashort. In third place this afternoon, Natalie Sesford. In second place this afternoon, had a great day, Madeline Steele. And coming first today and winning the big check, there is nothing better than a big check. Nicola McDonald, congratulations, Nicola. Nicola, if you can, come back and have a chat with Nettie just about today.
So, what was it like out there? How did you find the course?
It was a bit difficult, actually. Like, I couldn't really get a good line through that corner, but it was hard, like, coming out of the corners every time. It hurt.
Yeah, there's a lot of corners, especially if you have to do a few heats. What do you think of the Blackchrome event? Are you going to come back next year?
Yeah, definitely. I think it was really, run really beautifully. Like, it went really smooth, and I think it's a fun new way of racing and just to help during the COVID times when we don't have much racing, so yeah, for sure.
Awesome. Thanks so much for coming out and supporting the racing. It was great to see you out there.
Well done, Nicola. We're about to present the men's checks very shortly. Just while we're doing that, how lucky are we to be here? Beautiful Sunday afternoon here in Adelaide. Quality field of ladies, they've got to get their photos taken and some work on the video there, but this is what it's all about.
Absolutely, the weather couldn't have been any better. Not too hot, not too cold, and perfect for racing.
What is the worst kind of weather then for a cyclist? What don't you want in these kind of events?
Well, a lot of people laugh at the Aussies and say that we can't ride in the rain because we're not used to it. So whenever we go to a race in China and it's pissing down with rain, it's always a challenge just to prove them wrong. So even if I don't like it, I pretend I do.
Hello to the kids watching too on Blackchrome CC. She's using a bit of potty language here, Nettie. Family show. No, that's okay. Don't worry about that. It's terrific though, isn't it? So what would these cyclists now be thinking as the year goes ahead? What would you be doing at this time of year? In terms of these guys, so they want to come back and improve on this next year. What could they work on between this event and the next event?
Well, I feel like a lot of the organisers here at Blackchrome will go back and revisit and work out what worked, what we can improve on, and so whether we change the course a little bit. I know that this wasn't the plan to have it exactly like this, so we've had to make some adjustments at the last minute to make sure it's nice and safe. So whether we can do something a bit more technical or something slightly different, and then we're going to get those invites back out to those riders and see what they liked. Maybe if they also have some improvements, and then it depends what their schedules are, whether they're track riders, road riders. Usually we focus our training around the next event, so yeah, hopefully the Olympics goes ahead for the track. The road's still cracking on overseas in Europe. There are a few cancellations and postponements, so everybody's just sucking it up and waiting and see what can go ahead. So
I know we're presenting Kel with his big check in a second. Have you ridden this course? Would you like to have just a leisurely, casual ride around just to see what it's like? Don't injure yourself with the Olympics coming up.
I did have a bit of a cruise, although not at speed. Like we said before, when you have a race number on, you go through at a lot different speed, and there's a lot more things that are going on, so it was a lot safer when I went around. But it does make me a bit hungry to get out there, especially seeing the giant novelty checks. Everyone likes a big piece of card to show off to all their friends of how much money is up for grabs. 800 for the win, 550 for second, 350. 200. So the reason why there's a little bit more up for grabs for the boys is because they had another round. So we couldn't get the numbers in the women's, but so good to see so much support for these riders.
And as you were saying before too, you get some extra money when you win your heat. So that's why you don't just want to cruise. So even if there's only the two of you in the heat, you want to make sure you win. All right, let's announce the fourth to first winners in the men's. And coming fourth today, he's had a terrific day. Harry Holloway. Come on up, Harry. He's got to jog it out. Now, Harry, of course, fell in the final. But he seems to be moving okay. This check will help. That's going straight on physio bills, I reckon. Righto, coming in third this afternoon, getting his big novelty check. A great day of racing from Matt Franks. Coming in second, and could have easily come first today, but coming in second, another great day of racing too. Lee Howard, congratulations, Lee. And coming first, round of applause. You may have written him off. I was on him all day. I thought he was the favourite. Kelland O'Brien. Kel, come back for a chat.
So, what was your preparation like coming into this race today?
Yeah, pretty good. I've just been doing kitchen renovations all week, so haven't touched my bike in over a week, but happy to take the win.
Yeah, you didn't know how you would go today. Do you think how you're gonna pull up tomorrow?
Yeah, definitely going to be pretty sore. The first round today hurt pretty bad after not riding my bike for so long, but yeah, I had good legs in the end.
Awesome. Well, congratulations today and hope to see you back next year.
Is it a pretty civil sport? Are they all friends? Although competitive, are they friends?
Depends who's asking. But no, it's quite tough when you have to ride with your teammates, but also be up against them for selection. But luckily, these two are riding quite well, and they've both been selected for the Olympics in the team pursuit, so they can put away the competition and put on the supportive team member hats.
So that's it. That's it for the day. Annette Edmondson, cycling superstar, thank you for your work in the commentary booth today. It was a lot of fun.
It was fun. Sorry, a bit rusty, but I am new to this. I really enjoyed it and had a lot of fun with you. So thanks for making it good fun.
How great was the event itself? We look forward to it next year.
Definitely. It was really, really good. Definitely a great success. Awesome to see so many people out, so many sponsors out there supporting this race. Great work, Blackchrome, for putting on something different, something edgy, something for everybody. So definitely hope to see you all next year.
So again, in the women's, Nicola McDonald comes out first. Kelly O'Brien comes out first for the men's. A little bit of bragging rights too when it's the inaugural event, because you'll always have that on your competitors. The first one, I won it.
Definitely.
What does your year look like before we let you go?
So we are on our final build for the Olympics. Hopefully they're on this year. If they're not, I think it'll be finished forever. And then it will just be the next cycle in 2024. So final build, and hopefully we'll be racing and lining up in Tokyo come August.
We look forward to that. Will you be here next year for the Blackchrome Velo GP number 2?
Well, definitely. It depends on whether we hang the bike up, but I feel like I'll just have to take the suit out for one last hurrah, perhaps.
That's a yes. Thank you so much for being with us this afternoon on Blackchrome CC. Thank you to the crowd who came here to the Western Suburbs, the great suburb of Beverly this afternoon. Thank you again to Blackchrome for the event, to all the sponsors, to all the people that helped out, from St. John's to the volunteers to the commissaires. Thank you so much for all your work. Leith Forrest, Annette Edmondson, saying goodbye from Beverly.